the bullshit aside, swallow my pride, but nah, I couldn't let it slide. You say you want me, but you ain't doing it right. You must be tripping if you think Zero need you in his life.
Use a bee. Don't you ever get tired of acting like a bee? You ain't she. Can you please get up off my with that shit you be on? Cause all I need from you is to get the fuck on. So that start of the Funkery show right there, Zero Use a Bitch. Some of y'all around here, we say it every couple of weeks, but some of y'all are some bitches. And I don't want to be toxic around here. New year, new me, or new year, same me, or new year, same toxicity. But we'll get into that, obviously. I've got a few instances of bitchery to get around here. So again, Rashawn here, Kendrick here as well. Although, before we get into why some people are a B,
We are back.
Yeah, we are back. First show of the year. I've got to also halfway share why I'm also being a bitch. But I'll get into the full story at the end of the show. However, obviously last week I was not here. But I'll give you a couple of hints, right? Because this new year has probably been the worst new year that I've ever had. Which I'll get into at the end for those that would want to listen, obviously. Usually when, you know, you start the new year and shit's fucked, it usually comes from your own volition. But this time it's something very different. But like I said, we'll get into that at the very end of the show. Hendrick knows already. But now it's time for me to transition from me being a bitch to others being a bitch. So I don't have the... let me just find where this is. So I saw there was a complaint topic, Hendrick, on QNVN. What, I don't know what data it was. Let me just try to find and pull up here. QNVN got a complaint topic from Indicator. I'm trying to find where the hell it is here. I didn't have a chance to link anything before because I just came back from somewhere. Okay, I found it. I'm going to link the first post here, ladies and gentlemen. And we're going to watch the video together. Right? It is on Metal TV, which honestly I hate. I don't like Metal TV at all.
I was just thinking today how every time you open link, it's like telling you, asking you to try out, install their like program, I think. And each time I click no, I use pros.
Yeah, that's a hell no. Like,
that is,
I don't know if I'm forcing, old school or some shit.
Yeah, that is forcing, and it's not working. It's not making me interest the program.
Absolutely not. It was like Plays TV back in a few years ago. It's like, bruh, just record your shit, man. That is Plays TV bullshit. You can't even, I don't know. I don't know if it even says a local recording, but we're going to watch this video together, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know how long this is, but we're going to do it in its entirety. So I'm going to click play right now. That didn't do it. Okay, so I see here full health, full armor, full vehicle health for Indicator, right? QNVN drops the spike strip, which no one can even fucking see. Indicator then hits the spike strip, and at this point, right, he's about to be a sitting duck, but the deed is not done, right? Because as a cop, you have to very safely be able to get your arrest and move on without being destroyed. You know what I mean? So Indicator gets his ass rammed quite a few times here by Q and VN, right? Vehicle health keeps on going down. He's peppered him. He's trying to get that car to despawn, obviously, since electric cars don't go on fire, blah, blah. Down to 41 health. Right now, QVN's got a really good situation right here. There's no way he can fumble the bag right here. Indicator keeps on running, goes to this house. QVN runs his ass over. He gets out. Arrests him. When I look at this video without any prior context, even though I had the topic to look at, I'm like, this is a textbook arrest. Textbook, ladies and gentlemen. Textbook. If somebody did this to me, I'd be like, okay. He did what he had to do. I would do the same thing. I don't use spike strips because I'm not very coordinated. What is this? What is this?
I'm just showing what I do while doing this.
Oh, I didn't know you could do this.
Yeah, me too.
We've learned something new here today. We actually came all on the stage, which is what I've always wanted to, like, do. But, again, like I said, I look at this arrest and I'm like, alright, textbook. I do the same thing, minus the spike strips, because I'm not very good. I do this shit. And if someone did this to me, which is, right, knock my car down to as low vehicle as possible. If I had a cyclone, fuck me up. Pause until the car disappears. Pepper me a bit, right, so I cannot attack back. I'd be like, ah, shit, you know, the man did what he was supposed to do. The man did in order to secure the arrest and to keep himself safe, literally, not the acronym. And then I take a look. So, guys, first of all, the skull and crossbones at the top, at the bottom left, right? Does that mean he's on death row? Is that what that means? Because
I don't know.
That would further prove the points. Fixie said, yeah, perfect. So Indicator was on death row.
No, that means he was actively resisting.
No, he wasn't actively resisting for all of that, though. But there is a skull and crossbones at the bottom left, like left of his wanted level. If he was actively resisting, we'd show it. But, you know, Kimvian says yeah, and Fixie says yeah. So I'm just going to say that he was on death row. So, before the encounter, right? Full health, full armor, death row, cyclone, full vehicle health. Right? All of the markers of hostility, right? And I see Indicator on the topic says, where is it? Says, I understand that when shooting felons car to disable it, you may accidentally shoot a few stray bullets. He just made sure that I can't even fight back after the car was destroyed. Let's go over a few of those, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, if we assume that the vehicle, or the car rather, had armor tires, which is, you know, again, like I said, full health, full armor, death row, full vehicle health. Right? All the classic signs of him knowing what he... The classic signs, rather, of him knowing how to play the fucking game, right? It would be clear that he had armor tires as well, blah, blah, blah. But he, you know, Kimbian took them out with spike strips. But yeah, once the spike strips are done, right, the cop's priority, of course, is to try to get the arrest, but in a way that you don't end up dying yourself, okay? When, I haven't been around very much lately, but when I was, if a cop shoots my head, I ain't Quaron. I ain't mad at that. They're supposed to do whatever they're supposed to do in order to to stay alive while they get the arrest. And this notion that QNVN was supposed to give him an opportunity to fight back is completely asinine. I don't understand where that even comes from. This is a competitive, or it should be, a competitive server, right? Cops versus robbers is a competitive type shit. Why would I give a felon an opportunity to fight back at me? QNVN did exactly what he was supposed to do in this damn video, and there was nothing that he did wrong here. Let me show you something, ladies and gentlemen. Right, I don't know if Tony Soler is around here, but Tony Soler is a great example of this. I'll show you two videos here, alright? There are times where being a good cop can be a good thing. And being a good cop as in, you know, you hold your fire as much as possible, right? And if... What is Rashoff doing, bro? Son of a bitch. I'm wondering where that sound is even coming from. And I don't know how to stop it. Rip Sun, ladies and gentlemen. I think Rashoff is not likely to... So now we're echoing. Son of a bitch. Rashoff is not like the 2-week layoff, I think. But there are times where being a good cop, quote unquote, can give you some iconic good shit to happen to you, right? Oh, this is the wrong one. The Tony Soler against Indicator in P2R a few weeks ago, right? Back when swimming in the water was not resisting, he would always be like, hey, if I'm going after somebody who goes in the water, I'm swimming after him. That's what Tony Soler does, right? And sometimes, folks, it works out for people like Tony Soler. You know, sometimes like that, it turns into that. But there are also times, ladies and gentlemen, where being a good cop, quote unquote, as in, you know, hold your fire, try not to kill, try not to arrest. Or excuse me, try not to kill, try not to, you know, shoot too much, blah, blah, blah. Sometimes it can turn into this. I guess it didn't link.
Oh.
Yeah, you just click on the link, and then I'll take you to it. But sometimes it'll turn into this. This video here, the second one I linked. Tony Soler going trying to chase Exogenesis, right? Tony Soler ain't shooting. Exogenesis is, you know, giving the illusion as if he is a peaceful felon, right? He goes up to the jewelry store and he parks his car. He gets out. He takes the gun out, but Tony Soler comes out and thinks, ah, shit. Easy arrest. He doesn't want to fight. He's got the taser out, for fuck's sake.
Oh,
you know? He's got the taser out, for fuck's sake. This is what cops would want to prevent, ladies and gentlemen. This is what cops would want to prevent. You cannot give a felon a chance to turn on you. And we've talked about this before in the past, you know? I don't know what this garbling is coming from, bro, but, we've talked about this in the past, ladies and gentlemen. Whenever I would be a felon, there would be times where I do not immediately fight a cop back. I take a look at my surroundings. I take a look at my health, his health, my armor, his vehicle health, mine. And I'll make a decision with the next X amount of seconds as he's chasing me. Do I want to turn on the cop or not? Now, if the cop knocks my health down enough, then at that point I realize it's too late. I can't attack him back. It is my responsibility as the felon to decide whether or not I want to turn on the cop. And as you see in this video right here, Exogenesis has perfectly made this play. He made it seem like he was innocent or, you know, not belligerent. He gets out of his car. Tony Solar is like, ah, shit, easy arrest. Just about to tase this cocksucker. And all of a sudden, he's dead. Not even a speck more of armor has been taken off Exogenesis. So at this point, gentlemen.
Yeah, rest in space.
Yeah.
For Tony.
Space for Tony Solar.
Yeah.
So at this point, ladies and gentlemen, all these people they're talking about. Ah, shit, well, he shot my skin. Okay? What is your point? If you go to jail with 79 health or 34 health, what does it matter? There ain't nobody coughing in the jail. Right? It doesn't really matter. As long as the cop doesn't kill you, while you're not resisting, obviously, I don't see a problem with this because, like I said, I would do the same thing he did. And if a cop did it to me, no issue whatsoever. This is just the game. That's what it is. So when I see complaint topics like this, I'm like, hello? What are we really complaining about here, ladies and gentlemen? I don't know what it is. Go ahead.
It's like the way I see it. Most of the time, like you said, criminals, they decide the next move, like how's the situation will go. And this type of tactic, what Vien was using, is like a counter plan or tactic to against that. And I think I would be lying if I said that I've never done the same. And sometimes even I think I've gone too far, maybe, who knows? And I've actually even killed the guy because at the right moment he didn't have the red star. But yeah, I see. Just
yeah.
I do remember too many times and dying myself because I decided to wait too much and wait till the other player, criminal, has, you know, the upper hand because he can pull out that rifle anytime, and then I might be holding something else or my position would be bad or like, yeah, that's why in America cops shoot you instantly. I understand it after playing this game, like I've told it before. But yeah, you get like paranoid after dealing with so many criminals who pull out the gun all of a sudden when it's a good time for them. And while you deal with people like that many times, you kind of, you know, expect it to happen. You just don't know when, and sometimes you shoot them because of that. Could be your fault still, but, you know, that's like a reaction, a reflex. Because you're so, you know, you're just waiting when it happens. So
yeah, exactly. And I would suppose, best believe, that if Q and VN didn't knock those spike strips down, that indicator, seeing as he was on death row and had full everything, he would have tried to retaliate. Right. Here have been the thing, ladies and gentlemen, right? He basically gave up after the spike strips were put down. But at that point, it is your responsibility. If you give up, give up. Right? What he could have done was, as he was getting rammed, or in between getting rammed, he could have, like, jumped out of his car, surrendered, You know? I mean, it's also part of your responsibility as well. Like, he could have, if he really was done with the fights and didn't want or didn't have an opportunity to turn on him, he could have done his part in surrendering, which he didn't do. Instead, and I hate these types of complaints where people just, it's 40 seconds of, hey, look at me, look what he's doing to me. I just, you know, I just feel like, I don't know how to even explain it, but, you know, 40 seconds of, hey, look at me, this is happening to me, and it's wrong. So take it in, even though I could have done this a different way. I don't know, as would it be. Anyway, I've got a bone to pick, Hendrik, a little bone to pick. I'm going to talk shit on the admins for the fast next couple of minutes.
Okay,
talk shit on the admins, yeah?
I'll just act surprised if it's not about me.
It's not about you, actually.
Whoa.
Not about you.
2024, looking good so far for me, huh?
Yeah, your rep is starting to go back up after it.
After all.
Back in 2022.
But
Ganja Monster. So there was some shit I saw.
That's
about
the
Ganja Monster,
I think.
No, that's Sergeant Martin Riggs, I think. No.
Oh.
Sergeant Martin Riggs is the medic. Ganja Monster, he plays as many things. But I saw Ganja Monster. Yeah, I saw Ganja Monster the other day, Hendrik. Oh. And
How did he look?
Well, not like that. But he had, I don't know if it was a combat MG or an MG. One of the two, right?
Oh, yeah, that one.
It was the MG.
It was the MG, yeah. Thank you. So, I suppose there's probably somebody out there. I don't know if it's him, if he got it from his own, like, cash or whatever. But, how long ago has it been now since both of them have been, like, you can't get them from Gunrunner shit anymore? It's been a year and a half, probably more out now.
I remember fighting with that gun.
And we all did.
I was fighting, like, Anka with the gun. Or he was using it against me. And yes, what I said. And it's been a while.
It's been a big while, yeah.
Yeah.
The policy at that time, Hendrik, was that whoever still had it would keep it. It's just that Gunrunner Caches would not sell them anymore. But with that, you would have expected over the next couple of months for it to slowly go to zero, right? But there would be outliers of people hoarding it for a rainy day, right? So that was the decision at that time, right? There would always be a thought that somebody in 2024... late last year, or even next year, that somebody would find a way or bring out an MG from their ass, right? And it was only a couple of screenshots I saw. Ganja Monster was wrecking a few people with the MG. I don't know who complained or what, but somehow it resulted in his weapons being cleared, which, as I said before, if you make the decision to not wipe the gun from everybody's inventories, you can't do this. You can't do this. He got his guns wiped, and I don't know if he bitched or not. This is one of the few times, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, yeah,
exactly.
He did.
Yeah, but this is one of the few times, ladies and gentlemen, I always talk about bitching about people bitching. But this is one of the few times where that is warranted. Him bitching about his guns being cleared is completely and utterly warranted. Because if it was really a concern that somebody in 2024 would be using the MG, then it should have been cleared back in 2022, whatever year it was. So bad on us, obviously.
Yeah, the whole removal of all the MGs, it was like a temp solution. It wasn't a perm solution. So Mr. Wick, there were people like Mr. Wick who still had it for sale.
Yeah, and I'm sure there are others as well. But
you think it would be common sense to remove like a gun that you want to ban from all sources it could be found from?
Exactly. And I'm sure next year or some shit, I don't know who still has it, but there will be some instance where somebody will have it. And you just got to keep
it. I think I would like, if I had something rare, I knew it would be rare if I, you know, just waited enough. I would keep, I would save it and then, you know, just maybe flex with it. You know, there are people who call themselves like car collector people. They collect cars, and you know, I can see why someone could be the same about guns. I collect guns. See what I got here, this bad boy over here. Yeah, back in my day, we used to use, you can't have this anymore, but I do have to. What do you think about that, yeah? You know?
My day, huh?
Street credit. That's how you, you know, make your name. Make it known.
Yeah, well, here's the thing, Andrew, you know? This is what Ganja Monster did. This is what he did.
I got us some cannons in the trunk. Holy shit, where'd you get all this stuff? Been saving for a rainy day.
That's what he did. Save it for.
That's good.
Save it for a rainy day. That's what it
is. Get a respect of him. Like, he was, you know, I bet he had many situations where he was like, shit, dude, I gotta win this battle over here. Should I use it now? Should I use it? I want to win. I want to kill. No, please wait. Save it for a whole time. He was like that. And now the time came and now it's gone. Do we know?
He destroyed the server, huh?
But do we know if he is it the, like, is it the last one to have that, or are there still people who are having?
Chances we don't. Chances Mr. Wick probably still has them on his inventory.
Mr. Wick.
Yeah.
There has to be at least one person that has these guns in their cell inventory.
Yeah.
Mr. Wick probably still has.
Yeah, hang up the phone. You will be receiving a lot of calls after this.
Yeah, he can get a lot of money off of that.
Unless they were all then and then reset, so. Part removed, so
I have no idea.
I just doubt that.
Jinasuke said that Ganja Master, though, was generously compensated for the remover of all weapons. Well, considering he has like $1 billion,
I don't know if he's gonna help, huh? You know, like, if someone wins in your city, let's say a big lotto, like many million. And then, of course, you might keep that information to yourself if you are the winner. But your neighbors will get suspicious at that point when you are getting a new car or you dress differently, like some say better. So I've been looking at that guy, and I think he's holding up to some money.
He's got a lot of hidden money, does he? Hidden shit.
Yeah.
You never know, man. Well, we'll see about that. Shout out to Ganja Monster, by the way.
Yep.
Next up, Hendrik. I see Wizzy. I didn't know that he was expecting to be here, actually. I'll get his ass up here.
Who is
the young boy up here? Because the next subject is, I think, in his wheelhouse here. So, Hendrik, the transition. The transition, pause, has been made. Dusty Flops vehicles.
Oh, yeah.
That's what the hell?
I haven't
Dusty Flops vehicles yet. Have been removed from the server. As far as I see right here.
Yeah. I heard so.
And a lot of clothing items.
A lot of clothing items gone. A lot of the dusty flop footprint has gotten its ass out of here. It has been some of the cars obviously have been replaced, right? The riot van, which we'll talk about a little bit later in the Agriere. The Agriere was.
Bro, you put me up here, and there's five people left. I'm starting to feel. Oh. First of all, you know, you waited like an hour to put me on, and you skipped two topics, which I would have joined in. And then you put me on this topic, which, yeah. But five people already left. I think I'm starting to feel a bit of a, you know. Yesterday, Navarro said, when I asked him when I'll have my own segment here, he said, no segments for rioters. So I feel like I'm being pushed out slowly.
We are testing you.
In a place where I already wasn't a part of, so...
our conversation was that we were going to get you your own show. Wasn't that our conversation?
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Maybe I can warm you up.
Hey.
And, yeah.
That's a pause.
if I can just have, like, a couple of minutes. So, first off, 2024, has there ever been a year that starts off weirder, okay? So 2024 started off, right? The first thing that fucking happens is in Miami or wherever it is, you get fucking reports of 10-foot tall aliens. And like 500 cops go to like see what the fuck is going on, and there isn't a single video of anything that happened there. Then, a couple of days later, you know, you get Jews coming out of the fucking sewers in New York or whatever, you know. And why are we wondering that our personal lives? Because I saw you at the start, you know, you said that it's been a shitty start to the new year. Like, look around, man, everything is fucked. Like,
yeah,
this shit is fucking crazy, you know. Tentacle alien recorded over Iraq or where, what, you know, whatever. Like, what the fuck.
Yeah, so, I'm messing with the tentacles, so damn sure. I don't know what's going on there. But, it's the meme here.
I see so much, and then, you know, I think NG is having its own crisis with snowflakey complaints. If you look around, every single complaint, the amount of complaints, and I just like to point out, maybe somebody is going to get insulted by this, but if you go to, like, player reports, and you see your name 10 times as the reporter, maybe you should see where the problem is, you know? Because maybe the problem isn't the other players, especially if every fucking second or first post is dismissed, you know? Like, it's so snowflakey. Q and VN, you said everything that there is to say about that stupid complaint. but there are some other complaints there, like, you know, somebody just touches somebody else. Somebody just looks at somebody wrong. And even, you know, Mr. Wick. I love Mr. Wick. He's, you know, I think he's a very nice guy. But, I mean, trying to sabotage your robbery? Come on, man. That's not a rule break. That's never been a rule. Come on. Like, if we can't... back in CB, the moment you started to rob the bank, somebody would chainsaw you and then say, easy, you know. That was toxic. That was rule breaking. This trying to steal your car, it's shitty, but, you know, kill them and just tell them, you know. It can't be a rule break. That's what I'm trying to say. It's provocative, and to some extent that might be good for the, you know, place getting, you know, people playing and hitting each other and killing each other. It might not be too bad, but it's not rule breaking, you know. And, you know, all of these fucking complaints, every single every second complaint is dismissed. I mean, this means that the people who are complaining aren't doing it right. They aren't doing it for the, you know, for the right reasons.
Oh. Yeah, I'll give the new guy, I know who you're talking about, I'll give the new guy some leeway because he's new, right? I mean, he spammed the flare for it section, but he's new, like, you know, I'll give him some leeway, but everybody else, yeah, I see what you're saying there.
Yeah,
There's a lot of.
They should just. I mean, start fixing shit by yourself. You know, if somebody kills you, place a hit on them. Don't complain them. If somebody tries stealing your car, place a hit on them, kill them. You know, but don't complain about every, because that's how you kill the active gameplay, is by the moment that somebody, you know, tries doing whatever it is to, like, gain an advantage over you. And there is the other thing that I wanted to talk about. Who, and they are never going to admit this, but is the little bitch who complained about getting killed by Ganja Monster going to ever admit, oh yeah, I did that. I was such a little bitch that dying in a video game, and in which life insurance either costs 40k or absolutely nothing because the medic will revive me, or he's going to give me my money back, which Sergeant Riggs does. Is the little bitch who did that going to admit, oh yeah, I did that? I was such a little bitch that I couldn't handle getting my ass kicked by a guy who, by the way, didn't do anything wrong. What he did was tactics, you know? Okay, this weapon is removed, but I'm going to keep it in my inventory and use it at a later point. You don't have that weapon because you weren't playing at that point, or you weren't smart enough to keep that weapon. That's a skill issue. That's a skill fucking issue. It's not the issue of, oh, this guy's doing something wrong, I should message the admin about it. It's such little bitches. Like, how can you be so soft to do that? And especially, you know, towards Ganja Monster, who's a guy I really like, and the money, we all know that recently, for some reason, he acquired a lot of money.
Some reason, huh?
In some back channels.
Yeah.
But I mean, come on, you know. Seriously, complaining for fucking killing you, Jesus. And I don't know the MG that much, but I think it doesn't give you a chance to, like, move around a lot. At least not as much as a normal weapon. So yeah, so just absolutely horrendous.
Here's a prop of a complaint topic I'll give, though. And I'm going to give Lava his praise, all right? Every time I say Lava's name, I always talk shit. But I'm going to clap for him right here, okay? Because there was a very interesting complaint topic that I had seen from him against the Massey last week. And so Massey got that ass banned. I'm trying to sound here. He attacked his own hits. However, he did it with commands, or, you know, a command attack.
Oh, yeah, that was a really funny video. Of him just fucking running and just headbutting him.
He headbutted him and he stunned him and then he got his ass destroyed. But I don't know how much commentary was on that, but I'm gonna be on Lava's side this time. Very rare, ladies and gentlemen. Lava's side this time. I will say, you know, because usually when you talk about attacking your own hit, it's usually with guns, right? But I guess Massey was like, shit, you know. First of all, command attacks aren't DM. There are some people that are talking like, oh, he got banned for, you know, command attacks, DMs. No, the DM was not part of it. It's because he had hit on Lava, used command attacks, right? He headbutted him. But even though we don't talk about it that much, it doesn't really come up, but command attacks, if you have a hit contract on the person, you headbutt them, that does count as attacking your own hit. You know, Beavis and Butthead, all them shits, you know.
It depends what command attack it is, come on. I mean, if I gas around you and you die, fuck off, you know.
Well, yeah, one that does direct damage, yeah.
Especially headbutt, you know.
Stunning them, too.
Yeah, so. Cough maybe as well, to some extent, I can see. You know, if you're on really low health, something like that.
The idea usually is, you know, you place a hit and you get your ass away from them, but...
All right, but to play the devil's advocate here, how long was that ban?
I don't know. Has anyone seen him play lately? Because I don't know.
Because, I mean, okay, why? It's what he did was wrong. I'm not going to say what he did was perfectly okay, because clearly, you know, wasn't. It directly resulted in his hit being completed, and he attacked his own hit. It's rule break. Why don't you just hand of God the motherfucker like 3-4 times and let him play, you know? That's all I'm saying. And here, you know, he might have had previous But I'm just putting it out there. You know, he might have done this again before, and you know, not learned from warnings and things like that. So I'm just going to throw it out there. I don't know the whole situation, so you know, I'm sure Gino will be like, "Oh, I warned him like 50 times before." So
just putting it out there. Always on the edge, you know. He's always on the edge. So.
He's edging. He's edging 24/7 while he's playing. I'm sure. Yeah. Him and Beavis and Butthead, they're just edging and Palma, all the time, man.
Yeah, it's a circle jerk.
They never stop edging. Yeah, yeah. They sit around and just edge.
But yeah, and you saw it live on video in a lot of his videos. So, he is still banned. That's all I can say. He is still banned. So,
rest in peace.
Rest in peace. Yeah. I'm usually not a big deal type person anyway, so whatever.
So now we have default cop cars. I've seen them. I've even had the possibility to try them yesterday. They're absolutely awful. Each one of them look like a fucking what was that? The cringy electric vehicle, the first hybrid that ever fucking existed. You know, that fucking box type of car, you know.
Prototype
it's
Tesla.
A meme car. Oh, it's a Prius. Each one of them looks like a Prius that was like painted over. But that's GTA 5, you know, developer's fault.
Yeah, the Enforcer got nerfed into a Riot van. So those guys in the Greery were going to have. The Enforcer did get nerfed, ladies and gentlemen. It's now a Riot van. So.
Yeah, very good.
I see the SC1, the Fury, and T20 are now, you know, police vehicles.
You know, I haven't tried the new T20, actually. I haven't tried the new T20. I'm going to use this opportunity. Now we had this whole thing that happened with the cars, you know. The cars got removed. So, and it's a big deal to some extent, but to some extent, I feel like. And yesterday, I had a talk with somebody, and I got some insight. And I still decided that I was going to like raise the issue, you know, today. It's probably because I want the community to see it, and maybe the community is like asking themselves some questions as well. But so today, for instance, Fallout London, and that's a mod for Fallout 4. They announced that they're going to be releasing the mod because it's still not released 4 months after their original plan date. Mm-hmm. And those guys, you know, trying to create that mod, that's 50 people from what I learned. They have a 50 people team that's programming the mod, creating, you know, everything around it. Meanwhile, in our community, you know, not to name names and things like that, but if we start counting, we have three admins who do programming, three admins who implement the new changes, three admins who do it, you know, constantly and deal with the really big things. I'm not talking about, you know, the small bug fixes, but I'm talking about, you know, really big ones. So you can see, you know, I see so many suggestions, you know, constantly about new things to be added, and about, you know, people joking, where is Casino coming, you know, I want this, I want that. But I really feel like in the future, and I tell people to, when you're doing the suggestions, really think about whether what you're suggesting isn't a bit too much when you're thinking about there's a three-person team that's doing everything, you know. And I don't think this moment, like right now, we need anybody to make new cars or things like that. I feel like that's, you know, right now not needed. What we need is, and that's of course, you know, for the leadership to choose, what we need is those people, for me at least, from my point of view, to get some help, because the Casino is something very nice, but we all know that everybody who's ever programmed knows how much math goes into programming. And in the Casino, where you're calculating things, and you know, you have different games, that's even more math. So that's really taxing on people. So one thing I'd say is, in my own humble opinion, as a community person from the community who's not even close to the leadership, I feel like we need somebody from the community to step up and say, okay, I can program, you know, I do programming in my job, you know, I can do this, I can do that. I do physics simulations for a company that deals with fluid dynamics. I can probably help you guys with something. And maybe the community leadership should think about, oh, well, maybe we should, you know, see if this guy can't help us for real. Because right now, for me, the way things are going, okay, we're eventually going to have Casino, and then I know what the plans are for, like, other really big, really ambitious and really nice projects. But it's like, people are suggesting new things all the time. But are those things ever going to be able to happen if, you know, these guys, they need to fix bugs, they need to implement new things. There's more and more pressure on them. The community complains about stupid things. And now, you know, I don't know. It's my opinion that these guys need help.
Well, and, I'll say two things about that.
Yeah.
I don't think, like, when people make suggestions, I don't think people need to keep in mind that there are only three devs or whatever it is. I think that shouldn't really be any of their concern. I think they should have their ideas put forth, even as extravagant as it might be, and then the dev team can take it from there, whether or not it's too much for them to do or not. And the second thing...
How many people were behind coding CPCNR?
Two guys.
Yeah.
One and a half.
Of course, the players who play the game, they get ideas, they want to share it without thinking it more deep than that. Yeah. Some of their calculator be like too much, but it's interesting to read what thoughts go through people's heads. Some of them are crazy, some are like, oh, that's pretty good, that could work.
Yeah. Oh, here's the second thing. I suppose, you know, there may be a Joe around here that does know how to code. But I guess that would be a decision for the heads to decide, especially because, you know, despite whatever ability somebody might have, they're not going to want to bring anyone on because they can code. You know, they may have some other personality issue that could cause a problem as well. Remember, Hendrik.
Maybe you lose the code if the guy was coding. You know,
that's long term. Oh,
you know?
The person I spoke to yesterday, that's what he said. And then my rebuttal was, that's why you license the code. You know, everything you create, you know, right now I have a work contract with a company, but it's no different as if you're doing normal code. And in that contract, it says, everything you do for us is ours. No matter when you did it, it's ours. You have no rights over it.
License Dusty Flop's vehicles. License Render.
It's too late for that. It's too late for that.
It's true. Remember, Hendrik, Codex had made a bunch of clothing for the server, and once she went batshit, she requested to have them removed.
Yeah, women
so,
moment.
I don't remember.
Good.
But it's a surprise. And I just say, oh shit, we don't remember actually that it was yours, so we don't.
Yeah, but lesson learned. Get your license on.
I'm not saying like, you know, I have all the answers, Sway, but you know, I feel like when I was just talking about, you know, keep in mind in the suggestions, I'm saying when you see a different server that has mining ores implemented, maybe your first thought shouldn't be, we need to have mining ores, you know? Like, about how the things that you see can be implemented if they can fit in an already existing system and not, like, just standalone things that are, like...
Yeah. Like mining
have nothing
ores
to do with the gameplay.
Like,
yeah, I mean, this is not Minecraft and it's not Fortnite Legos, so... come on!
I will tell that to Yeri.
Eh!
You're right. Of course, like, if there are someone who, you know, health and they're like, people see him as option, and, you know, be trusted.
If they're a good dude, I suppose.
Yeah.
Speaking, though, of suggestions, though, right? Because mining ores don't got shit to do with anything, but
I agree.
Conceited, let's get to agree or re. What do you say? You just said agree, didn't you?
Yeah, I knew.
Yeah, it's time for some agree or re, ladies and gentlemen. Do a few of these here. Conceited. Conceited here had an idea for a vigilante cop mission. Now, again, not a Deb. I love this idea. Not a Deb. Not too sure how the Debs would do it, right? But it seems like it would be very similar to Grand Theft Auto vigilante missions, where you go somewhere, there will be a few like NPC criminals around. You kick their ass as a cop, right? You got to be a cop to do this. You pass a couple levels, you get some cash, and some actual action round here. So, Hendrik, vigilante, greery. Yeah, basically chasing after, let's say, NPC robbers instead of chasing after or destroying or DMing as you do actual people robbers. You know,
I was kidding. Of course, I support any idea for cops. Absolutely, yes. Agree. 10 times.
Big agree for Hendrik. Mega! Vigilante. Agree.
I mean, I agree, but we don't need this before, like, the core thing. This would be great to have, but it's a temporary solution and it won't bring players. What will bring players is improving everything else before adding new things.
Yeah, I mean, I guess the thing about it is it's kind of a time sink.
We can all say plus one to this. It does seem like a good thing to add, but generally, after everything else is probably in a better state.
I can see it. So it's a reef for now.
Basically. I mean, essentially, yeah. All suggestions that are improving the core design of the server is a reef from me.
Me!
Let's see that. Trix D wants a shout out. So, shout out to Trix D, ID172. Right? Give him a shout out to Wizzy! Agree-re! Some vigilante up in here.
I'm going to both agree and disagree with Vega and with... I actually agree with the suggestion. I think player versus enemy things can be really, really nice and a really nice time sink. And a really nice thing to bring players. But I feel like this suggestion would be best implemented after the suggestion by Anthony Bourdain, also known as Lex, which I know I'm kind of skipping forwards maybe, but we've already covered it probably. It's a really old suggestion. So the groups, version 2.0. So I think the next big thing after Casino, in my own opinion, before even Casino happens, we can safely scramble Casino and work on this instead. But, you know, the community is the community, you know. I don't remember the Latin saying, you know, void do, void populi, void do, or something like that. So I feel like I feel like permanent groups first, and then we have things like, you know, vigilante missions which you can do with your friends, you know, in the group, and then that earns your group rank and things like that. So, you know. And I feel like some of the single player missions, they can be really fun, especially like the ambulance mission for medics who don't have anything to do, just drive around and revive NPCs. Why not?
Exactly. The Barrow said something about if there was no casino, then there'd be like,
yeah, he's been saying that. That's every time he joins the server, that's the line he says. Well, we wanted groups, but you wanted casino. You're the boss, brother. Fucking tell them to fuck off. Make groups instead next time, you know? I hope he learned from this experience that he shouldn't listen to the community always.
Yeah, it's always learning. So is that a re? Yeah.
It's an agree, but after the groups get implemented.
Okay. I'll say agree. I like the suggestion. Of course, it can have priority later on in time, but, you know, people talk about money sinks. There needs to be, like, a time sink around here, and that would definitely be a time sink. So I like that. Next degree of Reed, there are about 4 people doing this right now in the location we're going to talk about, which this suggestion came from. Identify You made a suggestion saying Nerf Enforcers. Now, we'll say right now that the suggestion's already been dismissed.
Did we lose it? That'd be cool.
Well, technically it's been accepted because Enforcers are now gone. Yeah. They've been demoted to Riot Vans.
A cop Phantom what's the track? Phantom Gust.
Phantom Custom. I mean, the cops are going to find the way anyway here. But Identify You said that they're too OP. You can't shoot them through the windows. Multiple of bugs. I don't know what that means. And there's no way out for the felon. A lot of cops intend to use them knowing it's a literal cage. Although this has been suggested in lieu of Benny's, right? Because Benny's has been a hotspot as of late for people to have a chance to get rare cars in lieu of the insurance car clearing. You know what I mean? And I've heard stories, shout out to Marnix, the biggest tryhard cop on the server, right? Where there'd be times where people would clog up lanes leading out of Benny's with Enforcers, which have now been demoted, right? But that's the main reason why this suggestion came about, as far as I know. So, Hendrik, Nerf Riot Vans, agree or re?
Absolutely re.
Pro cop.
Me! Re! Yeah.
Gotta keep up. Keep up on that role.
Gotta keep up. See, I just took a look at the lanes here. I know that the right van is big, but yeah, it's not that big. It's not gonna clog the entire shit, you know? So. Well, man. Bega, agree or re? Nerf the riot van.
Re. If you, like, what's the point in having them, then?
Me! Re!
Like, There's always complaints. In fact, yeah, for like a decade now, there's always been complaints about the balance between felons and cops, warrants and cops. Yeah. Like, they have lots of options. They have the resist. They have immunities on foot. They have the immunity when they get out of a car. They have the taser. We all have our own set as well. So why can't we have an armored truck?
Yeah, exactly. Plus, it's useless.
And honestly, it was a anti-response to cops trying to prevent us from getting cars at Benny's because our cars were removed.
Yeah. So that's why Benny's is a hot spot right now. So. Would it be so a re from you, Wizzy? Agree or re? Nerf the riot van.
I don't know what you're talking about. Of course, I agree. No, I'm joking. No. Here's the thing about the riot van. Okay, I always agree with suggestions which, to my own, you know, opinion, give unfair advantage. I've tried using an enforcer as a cop. It's something that you still need skill to do. It's something that's still hard to do, and it's very easy to die in one anyway, no matter whether you're in siege or doing something else. And I've killed cops who were in enforcers. So to me, that, you know, says it's a different playstyle. It's useless in chases, but it's not overpowered at all. So, you know, complete re on that.
Complete re on that. Love
me!
That.
Re!
Shout out to the boy Lava, right? He used a enforcer. I got explosives in my fire hole. Why, shout out to Lava on that, obviously.
I like, by the way, I was going to say that I like the lava complaint on Massey because it was German versus German versus German. It was lava versus Q versus Massey, you know? It was German on German violence. True. You know?
Well, you know, one thing I hate is when countrymen suck each other's ass. So it's refreshing to see each of them fight, you know?
And get each other banned.
Exactly. Because here's the thing, man. Some of y'all Balkans, bro. Some of y'all in the individual country. Some of y'all kind of suck each other's ass. And it's kind of unbecoming, honestly.
Bro, that's not true. Okay. What you just fucking said is completely wrong. What you just said is completely wrong. Because we don't do that. Balkans, the only people that Balkans hate more than Westerners are other Balkans. That's a proven fact. Like, right now, I like Mr. Wick, but fuck anybody who's from Serbia, you know? I can say this right now, you know? And I can say our history, Bulgaria's history, is Bulgaria's history, not North Macedonia's. So, you know, Kiko and the other North Macedonians, they can come at me, you know, if they disagree with that. But we don't suck each other, you know? And fuck the Romanians, they aren't even Balkans. So I don't like anybody. You know, I like the Turks, maybe, because most of them are cool. But the Greeks are fucking awful, pretentious pieces of shit. You know, the Greeks and the Croatians both think that they're, you know, Italians. They live their whole lives thinking they're Italians. You know, their whole cuisine isn't the Balkan true one. It's the Italian one. Oh, I'm going to have my salad with a bit of fish. Like an Italian. Fuck off, dude. You're a fucking Balkan. Put the feta cheese there. Put the, you know, tomato and fucking cucumber. Be happy with it. You fucking psycho. Fucking fish everywhere. Oh, we have our wine. Like, true. Fuck off. So, no, Balkans, we don't like each other, no. That's a lie.
Nix just said, tell Wizzy, the Romanians say, or we the Romanians say, fuck you too, man.
Yeah, you see, that's the way it should be. That's the way it should be. No, we do like each other, you know, because I work in an international company, and when I met, you know, Romanians and things. Okay, this is a really funny story. I met a Romanian guy, you know, while I was at work when I was starting, and he was talking about moving to Germany from the UK. So he lived in the UK for a couple of years, and then he moved to Germany. And he said, when I moved to Germany, I always used my UK passport, and I told nobody I was Romanian, and I only told them that I was English and I used my UK passport. And we died laughing, and nobody else got a why, but we as Balkans got why, because people, you know, people think that Balkans are retards. You know, so you just lie to people that you have nothing to do with the Balkans. So we understand each other on like that level, that it's shit here, and we try to make the best we can. So I think that's what brings us closer, you know, together, and that's why we understand each other maybe more than some other people do.
It's like siblings. They hate
each other. Also love for Romania.
Love for Romania, obviously. Nix as well. Last degree of relay, ladies and gentlemen. Pat Mudik put one
out. Fuck that guy.
But he came up saying that we need a brainstorm on how to modify the workers of the week. Mainly, I think Orchestra, he quoted something Orchestra said, and if I'm saying this correct. What? Oh, hold on. That's Cat, bro. You put it in the suggestion part. The suggestion forearm.
I agree.
I don't see this suggestion for some reason.
Of course.
Multi-time workers of the week. Okay, I saw it. Yeah.
But yeah, Orchestra had basically said that, you know, it's too based on missions and legal jobs and all that. Because, of course, if you're getting the cop cabinets, it's probably difficult or very difficult to actually win it by just doing cop work. You'd have to, especially during downtime, get some missions going and shit like that. Basically, I suppose the agreeery is that it should be more of a point system, not a money thing. And it should be weighted more towards illegal jobs for civilians and arrests and takedowns for cops. So, agreeery, Hendrik.
Yeah, I can see how that can spice things up when we're playing more for that purpose. They wouldn't be, I don't know, doing some missions like half AFK or something. I don't know. So,
yeah,
absolutely, yes. But also, like, the cop side of the thing, it's a different discussion, but if you arrest someone far away from the city, maybe the pay for that could be more or points. So, because of course, if you go that far and chase people that far, I'd prefer to be, you know, paid more. But that's like if we continue in the money, workers of the week. But yes, I like the idea. Yeah. Just, I don't want to think it too much, but yes, agree.
Tusher Killer said, those who agree, please keep in mind, medics who do fires will win over medics who actually help players or drive them around. Well, yes. As Jinasuk said, right, you can weight it. W-E-I-G-H-T, by the way, that's what I mean, weight. Weight it by, like, you get more points for reviving people who don't press the button. Over reviving people who already revived, over people who do fireman work. So it would be weighted, you know. Bega, agree or re, make workers of the week, you know, leaderboard shit, more weighted based on illegal jobs for civilians, cops, arrests, blah, blah, you get what I'm saying. Agree or re.
Okay, so Pat M himself is an edgelord, so he just made the suggestion possible. But aside from that, I agree with anything that, like, discusses the workers of the week. It's a very, like, it's one of the server's most major suggestions, major features. Yeah. I don't particularly care what they do with it, because I'm not active that much anymore, but whatever they do to improve it, they should
yeah,
because like I said, it's one of their major mechanics.
Yeah, and it would, for those that play all week, which God bless you, by the way, because I don't understand how you can, it would definitely get people doing some more action around here, I guess. So that's an agree. Wizzy, agree or re?
Yeah. So first, I feel like this suggestion needs to be, like, take some of the things that Rezzer said and take some of the really nice things that Chips said as well, just to be combined. I agree with the point system. Looks really nice, and I need to disagree with Tusher, because, I mean, come on, it's, you get the same amount of points for 50 fires put out that you'd get for 10 people revived. That seems crazy to me that somebody would, I mean, at that point, if somebody, like, puts out that much fire, you know, he deserves everything that he wants, you know. He's obviously, nothing can stop him on his way, you know, to becoming medic of the week. And it's you can't do it twice in a row anyway, so who gives a fuck, really? So yeah, I agree with the point system, and I also agree with what Chip said. I feel like this really needs an emphasis on it. A mayor should be the player who robbed the most from other players and shops, banks, any heists. This is cops and robbers. They are a pillar of the server and should be rewarded, encouraged more than any passive gameplays. I feel like this is really, really good suggestion. And I feel like, yeah, 100% agree. Put, you know, some points on the any amount of money you rob. Put some points on the amount of cars you get from bennies. And then the mayor is the guy who's, you know, got the flashiest cars and the most money and bought his way into that position as a criminal, because this is criminals versus cops. Yeah. Really good suggestion. Completely agree.
it's the flashiest cars and the hottest bitches.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what it'd be. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is agreeree. Let me just see how long we've been here, because I can figure it's been a long time here. Okay, I have not been recording, but okay, so I don't know how long. So, let's see here.
Sampula wanted to watch this on YouTube. Is he going to be able to, or did you just not record it at all?
Oh, no, the...
Oh, you didn't record time.
The mix thing is going to record the thing.
Ah, okay.
Just that I usually back it up or record while I...
I'm old like even, so you need to explain to me all the...
Yeah, me too, man. This works. Me too.
It's okay, Wizzy. When we set your new show up, I'll show you everything. All right.
Yeah. I'll be like the old guys in the movies. You know, this isn't working. Rashawn, come fix it. I can't get this to start. It'll just that reminds you shouting.
Reminds me of how I had to spend an hour with Ducati because he had some problem.
Come on, I'm not that bad.
Yeah. As would it be. Anyway, I don't see no hands up, even though that might prompt a hand to come up. So we're almost finished here, ladies and gentlemen, but I promised Hendrik that... First of all, yeah, Hendrik, I missed the summary
release
last week. Yeah, he... Summary 6, was it?
It was.
Yeah, would you want to link it in the chat here?
Me?
I guess I can do it. So I can.
If you have it, better.
I found it.
Okay.
Hendrik worked very hard on this video, ladies and gentlemen. So if you have
non-stop for a few days.
Editing videos is
for work. Big problem. Not proud of that.
Well, I'm sure you're good at the final product, you know? It's a pretty funny video, honestly, so... GG on that, man.
What do you think? You can be honest. Yeah, that episode against the trailer, which was better?
Well, funnily enough, when I watched this, I didn't even think of the trailer, so...
Oh.
Right. Yeah, because I thought... Ah, shit, what the fuck, man? This is going to be a four-minute video? Like, what the fuck? Am I doing? A minute and a half trailer. You're putting, like, half the video in the fucking trailer. But, a lot of content here. A lot of, some of this is aged content, but it's content nonetheless.
They are.
And, I liked it. There are a lot of fallen heroes in this video.
They are. Like, it reminds you how many people have dropped behind during the year. It's like basically a summary of the 23. It was the last summary. The 5th was like exactly 1 year before.
Exactly. So
there are even cars that were removed.
Yeah.
As well. Even fallen
makes
cars.
You remember.
Fallen soldiers of cars.
Fallen heroes. Yeah.
So.
You can also see Rashawn getting killed, which is always.
Oh yeah.
Not even 1 minute in and Rashawn is also a star in the...
Yeah, at least it was an unfair death, luckily. At least. If it was a fair death, I think my ego would be shot a little bit. But since it was an unfair death, I think we're all good. Although, you can see I tried very hard to lift up with the Molotov, but...
It was close.
It was being, really it was close. Being shit.
You got a fair
death. Yeah, you just couldn't get it up fast enough, Rashawn. Just couldn't get it up fast enough.
You got a would fair I, death? Would you have made a player report saying you took 150 damage?
Definitely would have. I'd be like, hey, you can't crash into my plane. That's DM, and you must compensate me, Andrew. That's definitely what it'd be. And Wizzy said I couldn't get it up? Yeah.
Pause,
yeah.
Happens to the best of us, sadly, yeah.
Hopefully I won't have that problem for the next, like, 40 years.
You never know.
I don't think so. But at least
next time you should hope it's not on video next time, you know. That would be worse.
not being able to get it up
again. Yeah.
Hey, yo. I don't know if they're doing that in doctor's offices, man. I don't think you need a video for that. That's what it'd be. But either way, Sam's almost finished, but I promised, Hendrik. As I was not here for the show last week, right? And I'm always here to do the show. It's only in situations of either seriousness or of anticipation from the opposite gender is when this show would be changed or impacted, obviously.
Do you know when was the last before?
When was the last time?
I can't remember.
I don't know. I think it was a few weeks ago, actually. But so again, last week I was not here, and I had said before that 2024 has been an absolute ass year. And I thought to myself, should I really say this? But I think I can deal with the repercussions if needed. But about 4 to 6 weeks ago on the show, Hendrik, I was making some type of meme analogy that I usually do here, comparing one thing to the other. And I said that somehow my dad got into this. And I said that since he's old, I said that if he were to go, I think I'd be ready for it. I said that here 4 to 6 weeks ago. I don't remember what show it was. Mm-hmm. Well, that has since happened. So on January 3rd, we don't know for sure yet, but we believe he had a stroke. This past Monday, he passed. So, yeah. So if you've realized that I've not been fucking around lately, that's the reason why. And that's the reason why I was not here last week as well. So a lot of family matters to be done in the next couple of weeks. Thank you, Candy Ass. Yes. So yeah, a lot of... yeah. Yes, thank you, men.
That sucks.
It does.
I can't imagine how the, yeah.
Yeah, there are a lot of more circumstances surrounding it, which I won't get into. But even though, you know, he was an old man, right? There's a lot of other shit I could say, but he was 91. So the man, he lived a very long life, obviously. It is quite different, obviously, and it was a little sudden, of course, but even though I had said that 4 to 6 weeks ago, it still doesn't make it easy, you know.
I don't think you're ever ready, honestly. I've been kind of close to that, you know. Both of my parents have severe health issues, and yeah. You know, there's a point where, you know, the doctor comes and tells you, you need to be ready, and, you know, maybe in a couple of days you're ready. Then you're ready in the morning, then in the night, you know, you're fucking crying yourself to sleep, you know. And yeah. You're never ready. You're never ready.
Yeah, man. Thanks, Nick, and everybody as well. Yeah, it's it been different, right? We were there on the final moments and shit. And, you know, I'm not used to this, so it was... very surreal. Even when I think about it now, it still feels like a new thought in my head. But, you know, the thing about it is, ladies and gentlemen, is that regardless of what happens, right, the days keep on going and life stops for no man. So even though we come around here and talk shit and we laugh and all that, you gotta make sure that your family is always in your thoughts. You know what I mean? So, you know, I just wanted to say that. And I'm glad that y'all could be here today, obviously, as usual. So, again, that'll been it for the Punkery Show, ladies and gentlemen. Again, thanks again for the condolences and all that. And part of the reason why I go on these tirades of people bitching is because, as Wizzy said, right, my dad had a lot of health problems for a good while, and he never really bitched about it at all, and he never let it stop him from doing what he wanted to do. Man was still mobile, still drove and all that shit, so he ain't bitch about a damn thing. So when I bitch about people bitching, that's probably where it comes from. I never really connected it like that, but yeah, so that's what it would be. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, that'll been do it for the Punkery Show, and we'll see you next week. If anything changes with that, then I'll let you know. So, thanks again, Bega, and also Wizzy for coming in, and yeah, for Hendrick. Nice. It was excellent. This has been Rashawn. That was Rashawn, who finally shut the fuck up. This has been Rashawn. We'll see you next time on Punkery Show.